Studios, Hollywood, and Florida. Welcome to the Sega Starcade Challenge.
Hello there, I'm Scott Baio. Welcome to Universal Studios Hollywood for the Sega Star Kids Challenge. Over the next 2 packed hours, you're going to see your favorite celebrity kids competing in a variety of grueling contests that will test their strength and their skill, not to mention their guts. And it's not all just for fun. These Star Kids are playing for 4 very good causes: Mothers Against Drunk Driving, United Cerebral Palsy, Easter Seals, and the Make-A-Wish Foundation. Joining me is someone whom you all know from Head of the Class, Rain Pryor. Hey, how's it going? Are you ready for this?
I sure am. And so are the Star Kids. You know, they tell me that it's a real change of pace for them to be doing something for charity instead of like taping a TV show or acting in a film.
Yeah.
And they love competing with kids their own age.
Oh, speaking of age, how old were you when you started on Head of the Class?
I was 19 years old.
Wow, late bloomer, huh?
No, I was busy flirting with all the guys, you know what I mean?
So you were.
So, Scott, how old were you when you started in Happy Days?
Well, I was 42, but they had a very good makeup team. Made me look a lot younger.
Yeah, well, they must have had, because you sure fooled me.
Well, we're not fooling here today. This contest is for real. And the big winners are the charities.
So, you seem like you're really good at this. I mean, have you participated in this sort of thing before?
I have been involved in a few contests, but this one is for kids. We have 4 teams in the Sega Star Kids Challenge. Each team has 7 kids here in Hollywood and 2 kids at Universal Studios Florida. Speaking of which, let's send it to Orlando right now and join Phil Moore of Nick Arcade. Phil.
Thanks, guys. We're here at Universal Studios Florida in Orlando. We're about to rock and roll and have a good time. Are we ready?
Yeah!
I would say that we are. Now, we've got 2 kids from each team and 2 events: the Sega Star Kids Challenge version of the Alphabet Game and the Terrible Web. We'll also pay a visit to the Wild Wild West Stunt Show, and our kids will get the inside scoop on how to be a stuntman.
Or woman.
Or woman from Hair Lady, yes. And as you can tell, these kids are feeling incredibly psyched. Right, guys?
Yeah!
All right, so who's going to win the contest? Okay, well, listen. Well, as you can see, we are all set for some hot and heavy action here in the Sunshine State. But now, let's send you back to Universal Studios Hollywood for some wild stuff about to happen there. Yeah!
Thanks, Phil. Everybody there looks really pumped. Also joining us here in Hollywood to get the real news from the trenches is our special roving field reporter from Beverly Hills 90210, Mr. Brian Austin Green. Hey,
all right. Boy, you know, it never hurts to add another go-hung to the lineup, I say.
What do you say? You feeling prepared for your job of getting us all the inside scoop on these kids?
Well, I don't think anything prepares you for the kind of hot and heavy action that's going to be going on, you know, out on the field, but I'm going to try to keep up with them if I can.
All right, well, we better get started. And who better to help us get things going than our commissioner for this event? After pounding away on the gridiron for the New England Patriots, the Cleveland Browns, and the Los Angeles Raiders, this man certainly knows what's tough and what's fluff. Mr. Bob Golic. Hey, Bob.
How are you guys doing?
So, Bob, have you had a look at our Star Kids team?
I sure have, and the great lineup of talent here just proves that you don't have to be a Pro Bowl linebacker to be a tough customer.
So, you ready to go, Commissioner Bob?
You bet, and we've got a great day of sport ahead of us with all kinds of competitions. There's something for everybody here. We've got boat races, foot races, even hedgehog races. I know, I'm excited too. We've got obstacle courses, crazy mazes, and dizzy waiters, and before we're through, we'll have these kids climbing the walls, literally.
Oh, that's a lot to get in, so we better get started. Let's meet our Sega Star Kid competitors. Our first team is playing for Mothers Against Drunk Driving. Here are the amazing Aqua Acrobats. He plays JT on the ABC hit show Step by Step, Brandon Call. Our Major Dad, she's the Major's middle daughter, Nicole Dubin. Also from CBS's Major Dad, Chelsea Hertford. From the cast of Fox Network's True Colors, Adam Jeffries. Director of Disney Channel's Kids Incorporated, it's Haley Johnson. He's Slater on Saved by the Bell, Mario Lopez. She plays Sarah Henderson on Harry and the Hendersons, Carol Ann Plante. For Nickelodeon's Welcome Freshman, Jill Setter. And we know him as Mark on ABC's hit show Home Improvement, Taryn Smith.
Now for the Easter Seals team. Here are the Blazing Blue Barbarians. She's Dorothy Jane on NBC's The Torkelson, Olivia Burnett. Young Indiana Jones himself, it's Corey Carrier. He's Joey Russo on Blossom, Joey Lawrence. From the hit TV series I'll Fly Away, Ashley Levitt. We know her as Becca Thatcher on ABC's Life Goes On, Kelly Martin. Since the age
age of eight, he's been growing up on growing pains. Jeremy Miller. Paul Pfeiffer on The Wonder Years, Josh Saviano. She played Stephanie on ABC's Full House, Jodie Sweetin. And from Saved by the Bell, Tiffany Amber Thiessen.
And playing for the Make-A-Wish Foundation, here are the courageous Choral Crusaders. From NBC's Blossom, it's Blossom herself, Maya Bialik. Miss Teen USA, Janelle Bishop. From the hit show, Home Improvement, Zachary Ty Bryan. Step by Step's own Josh Byrne. And he plays Zach on Saved by the Bell, Mark Paul Gosselaar. She's on Royal Family, Silver Gregory. From NBC's new show, Walter and Emily, Matthew Lawrence. We know her as Brenda Drexel on Drexel's Class, Brittany Murphy. And for 8 years, he's been Jonathan Bauer on ABC's Who's the Boss, Danny Pintaro.
And for the United Cerebral Palsy Team, also known as the Fabulous Fuchsia Team, from Evening Shade, it's Candace Hudson. She's Chrissy Seaver on ABC's Growing Pains, Ashley Johnson. Otis Drexel's other daughter on Drexel's Class, A.J. Langer. From Family Matters, Darius McCrary. He's a teenage Jesse James on The Young Writers, Christopher Pettit. From Nickelodeon's Welcome Freshman, David Roden. Home Improvement's own, Jonathan Taylor Thomas. Blossom's best friend, Jenna Von Oy. And from ABC, Step by Step, Angela Watson.
Like I said, Scott, it's a powerhouse of talent. Okay, guys, let's keep it clean and let's have some fun.
That's right.
All right.
The Sega Star Kids Challenge is being brought to you by Sega, leading the 16-bit revolution with Genesis. And by Three Musketeers Bar. Three Musketeers, big on chocolate. We'll be right back.
The Universal Studios Hollywood with a Miami Vice stunt show, location for our first event in the Sega Star Kids Challenge.
You know, Scott, normally this place is filled with surprise galore at every turn for those enjoying this part of the Universal Studios tour.
Yeah, but today it's going to be our kids who are making the waves in the first event, which is the canoe relay race.
And this is how it works. There are four competitors to a team, two to a canoe. The first canoe leaves the starting line for the designated dock.
That's right. When they get there, those two people jump out and two of their teammates get in, and they have to paddle as fast as they can to the finish line, and then obviously the team back to the finish line first is the winner, and that's it.
Well, that's not quite it, is it, Scott?
Yeah, they switch places, and the team back to the finish line first wins, and that's it, right?
No, I mean, they can do more stuff, can't they?
Like what?
You know, like teasing, splashing,
Of course, Ray, come on, that goes without saying. I mean, what's a good canoe race without a little messing around? Am I right, guys? I said no, we know what we're talking about. Okay, now I'll throw it over to Brian Green.
Scott, I've got two guys here who are both water nuts. Christopher Pettit from the Fabulous Fuchsia Fiends. Now, you do just about anything on top of the water, right? You do surfing and sailing and trick water skiing.
Yeah, I'm not in this event right now, but plan to get into the water later on today.
Okay, and we have Mayim Bialik of the Courageous Choral Crusaders. Now, because of your interest in marine biology, you like stuff under the water.
Yeah, I like all the animals and stuff under the water, and he is an animal on top of the water, so we're direct opposites.
Well, by golly. So, who's going to win this event, you think?
We are, for sure.
I don't think so. No, we are. You can see our team is much more ready than your team. We're going to win.
We'll get over there and see.
I'm here at the starting line with my competitors. I mean, the competitors. Are you ready?
Yeah!
So let's get sailing, guys!
Also joining us in the booth for the play-by-play, Alex Backus.
All set? On your mark. Get set.
There's the horn. Everybody off to a clean start. Aqua pulls to an early lead.
And Josh Saviano, Tiffany Amber seem to have the inside track here.
But the Aqua boat was Mario Lopez and Carol Ann Plante. Still fighting, seem to be holding that lead a little bit.
They're trying to push him into the wall, Bob.
I think everybody's got to fight to get that inside lane right now.
Uh-huh.
That shortest distance around that dock.
See, they just got pushed into it right there.
Fuchsia team is right in the dock there. I don't think they're going to make it out.
The team that seems to be able to control that corner may come out on top.
Where's the fuchsia team? Struggling.
Now, you got to remember, at the end of this first leg here, they're going to have to actually get out of the raft, get a second set of contestants in, and take it to the finish.
You're right, Bob. It makes that exchange all the more important.
So you see, Josh and Tiffany went too wide on the turn. I'm having a problem right now.
I actually don't think they knew what they were doing.
All right, here we are to exchanges. Who's that first boat to the dock?
Well, the first ones there are Mario Lopez and Caroline Plante. And taking the second leg for Aqua will be Nicole Dubik and Brandon Call.
Blue makes a good exchange. Coral's at the dock, too. The blue boat, Joey Lawrence and Kelly Martin.
They're having a problem, the blue boat. Joey Lawrence and Kelly having a problem getting in that boat. Here they go.
And Darius McCurry and A.J. Linger are still at the dock.
The coral team of Mayan Bialik and Mark Paul Gossler has made a great exchange and seem to be taking the lead.
And a tremendous push-up by Mario Lopez.
Oh, no, the fuchsia team.
We've got people in the water.
Overboard. Oh, no.
I think about half the fuchsia team.
A.J. Linger in the water.
Fuchsia getting their laundry done early. And the coral team already at the turning point. Look at them go, Mayim and Mark.
Pure teamwork.
Unbelievable. Joey Lawrence battling to get his team up for points, but Coral is going to take this one swimmingly. Look at Mark Paul showing everybody who the winning team is as Mayim Bialik brings it in across the finish line.
Nicole Dubik, Brandon Call coming in second. They took their second leg a little bit wide.
And Joey Lawrence still tries to get to the finish line.
Boy, when you take a look at this replay, you'll see that the exchange is where this race was won. Let's go to Scott with the winning team.
Congratulations, you guys.
Congratulations.
I got to ask one question. Who pushed you off the thing over there?
Geez, I really wouldn't know. I mean, it was...
Hey, no, that's a wonder for you guys.
I know that. Yeah.
Was... You were, I think, in second or third place.
Fourth.
I want to know who did it.
Well, I had the sort of distinct thought that might help us win. You know,
yeah,
it did help you win.
Yeah,
congratulations. Congratulations. Way to go, Mark.
Thank you.
Good job, Maya. Silver, congrats.
Darius and AJ are in another dimension, another time zone. The space shuttle can't help them.
Look at the scoreboard. Shows the coral team out in front with 100 points with that water-soaked victory.
And now get your popcorn ready for a Sega Star Kids home movie. Produced, directed, and shot by Darius McCrary.
She's getting all made up, too, just so she can get sweaty and messed up. You should have seen her when she fell in the water yesterday. It was hilarious. I mean, it was so funny. I mean, but there's not many women that can fall in the water and look gorgeous even when they get out.
What do you want? I give you a compliment. Come on now.
Angie, she's on my team. She did a great job on the water. She was holding the water, and she did, I'm bumping into things. She did a great job. Look at the back of Angie's head. That's the back of Angie's head, ladies and gentlemen. She's on step by step. She's tearing up the young riders, ladies and gentlemen. For all you ladies. Hey. This is crazy. Jonathan. Got in there. There's Jonathan. Jonathan. My homeboy, Jonathan. Oh, what can I say, Jonathan? Home Improvement. That's my boy. He's a dope. He's a bomb. He's a champion. She's good. AJ is an athlete, ladies and gentlemen. She's dope. The girl's dope. Okay, isn't she pretty? I told her she had on a wetsuit the other day, and she said straight skin in the swimsuit issue of Sports Illustrated. I was like, dang. And our mascot, Ashley. She's so adorable. Look at that smile. Hi, Ashley. How you doing, sweetie? What's happening? Really? You ready to do it?
I'm ready. I hope
we're ready. Me too. I'm the captain, you know what I'm saying?
We'll be right back at Universal Studios Florida, where the kids find themselves in a sticky situation.
We're back, and here's your host, Scott Baio.
And now down to Orlando for the next event in the Sega Star Kids Challenge. Over to you, Phil.
Okay, Scott, I got it. We are here at our next event here on Rodeo Drive at Universal Studios Florida, and this one is a beauty. It is called the Terrible Web, and that's what it is. I mean, just look at this thing. Now, the idea is one team member will start at the starting line and must get through the web to the other side where his or her teammate will be waiting to make the return trip. Now, Each team will run it and for the time, and the team with the fastest time will get first place points, second place points for the second fastest time, and so on. That is one catch. They must make their trip through the web while carrying water balloons. That's right, water balloons. And if they drop it on the way through, they have to go all the way back to their starting line and then come back with another one. And that's it. Let's get to the action. Let's do it.
We're ready for the web, and to start it off for the blue team, Jeremy Miller.
Jeremy is off. Starting off for the blue team, it's Jeremy from Growing Pains. He's climbing through the terrible web. He's under. He's going to take a chance. This is not giving him a problem at all. The balloon is still intact. He's making it through. He's making it through. He's almost near the end. Ashley's on the other end waiting for him. The handoff has been made, and Ashley's starting. She's through the web. Looks like these two have got a pretty decent strategy plan. Ashley's making her way through. The balloon is still intact. This doesn't look too terrible to them. They're handling this like they're experts at this thing. Look at her go. I cannot believe it. Ah, little leg hanging up there, but we made it out of that one. And she is out of there. Woo!
Ashley made it through the web with great difficulty, but she did get out and with her water balloon intact. The blue team's time was 34.45 seconds. That brings us to the fuchsia team. Leading off for the fuchsia team will be David Roden from Welcome Freshmen. He looks ready to go. The water balloon is in his hands. Let's see how he does.
Starting off for the red team is David. David from Welcome Freshmen. He's making it through. He's doing all right time. He's getting a little hung up because he's so doggone tall. But it looks like he's making his way down. He crouched low. Oh, he dropped the balloon, but it didn't break. So it's still good. If he can just pick it up. All right, it's still intact. He is out of there. He's handing it to Jenna from the hit show Blossom. Jenna is on her way. It looks like she may have an easier time because she's taking that low road. She's making it through. She's climbing through like a champ. She is flying. That balloon is still in her hand. She's not dropping it. She's almost out. She is out. Yes, great time.
Good job by that team. While David dropped the balloon, as you see coming up here, it doesn't break. Unbelievable. What a great break for that team. Let's see what their time was. 34.99. Next up is the Aqua team. Wow, Adam doesn't seem to know his own strength. Get another balloon, pal. Let's see if you can make it through with this one intact. That yellow one might be a little luckier. Here we go.
Yeah. Two colors is off right now. It looks like the blue team. Oh! Oh, we have to go back and start over. The blue team right now has a very, very small lead in front of the red team. Oh, he's down for the second time. It looks like now that the ground is wet, it's going to be a little hectic in there. I feel sorry for the next team having to come through, having to go on the wet floor. But Adam is making it now. He realizes his problems and he has conquered them. He is going through there like an expert. I don't know how he's going to do on time. Sometime may be able to be made up by his partner, Jill. And he's out of there. He passes to Jill. Jill is on her way. Jill from Welcome Freshman. She's going to have to use some scholarly moves in here now to get through and beat the time of the first two teams. Jill is making it. She has not. Oh, she's hung up. Look out, here comes the Spider-Man. Jill is making it. All right, Jill, she made it through. Got a little hung up back there, but she is almost at the end, and the balloon is still intact. She's hung up again. It's a kind of a wacky twist that they have in here. But she is messed. The head is out. If we can just get the leg out. All right, Jill. They made a great run. I don't know how it is on time, but they made a great effort.
Not a great start. They were to a minute 6.8. Look at Adam Jeffries. He hits the ground, the balloon falls, water everywhere. Next up, the Coral team.
Janelle is up. It's the Coral team's turn. Janelle, who is reigning Miss Team USA. She is making a look at her. Oh! The balloon popped on her. I didn't see her drop it. It must be a nail thing happening, but she makes it back. She's out. It's going to cost a little time. Right now, it looks like the team to beat is the blue team. All right, Janelle is starting over again. Up under through the balloon. She's giving them two handholds this time. Not want to run into that problem again. She ran into the last time. She is making it through. All right, she's at the final stage. Down under. All right, Mike, she is out. All right, and she's passing it to Zachary. Zachary, star of the hit show. Home improvement. He's making his way through. Oh, look at him. He's going to make up on all the time that may have been lost. Oh, the balloon dropped. And he's got to go all the way back to the beginning. Oh, talk about valiant effort, man. This guy is giving it us all. He's got another balloon.
Even though we're doing on time, but you know, we're going to figure out first, second, third, and fourth place. So time is still a crucial factor here in placing. All right, he's making it through the end. He's just taking a catwalk down the edge now. And he's keeping it tight. He's giving it that football hold now. Zachary is almost out. He is at the end. He sees the light at the end of the tunnel. There he is. All right.
Well, the web turned out to be a truly terrible experience for Zachary, Ty, Brian, and the Coral team. There he goes. There goes the balloon. Their time, a minute 16.74. That gives the victory to the blue team. Quite an event. Our score after that event, the blue Easter Seals team in first, United Cerebral Palsy in second. Uh-oh, water fight, balloons everywhere. Look at these kids, they're out of control. Hey now, Jeremy, hey now, watch it there, buddy. Oh my, these people are gonna know the meaning of wet. Oh, water, water everywhere. All in good fun, but it's time to find a towel, guys. After that event, Easter Seals, 150, Make-A-Wish and Mad, 125, and United Cerebral Palsy, 100 points.
I mean, with the winners, Ashley and Jeremy, 34.45 seconds. You did it by like a half a second.
I know, I did it by 0.5 seconds.
No, he was like, that is it. And you actually uptight because you had to go first.
No, he went first. I went last.
She was upset because we were going to go before any other team. But yeah. I picked it so the floor wouldn't be wet when we ran through.
Excellent move. And
yeah.
Never. You feel better about his choice now?
Yeah, I do. I thanked him afterwards.
And now, what about this? Now, you have this, like, wacky, like, water balloon fight here, and I just stayed the heck away from this.
I had to start it. See, Jenna and I have this thing going. Jenna and I are really good friends, and, you know, it's a long story. And so I had to throw a water balloon at her, and then we all started going,
I was trying to get you into it, but you held the microphone. I didn't want to.
That's right. See, I would have been shocked, and I would have had the buckwheat look, so I couldn't get involved.
Get wet either.
No?
Now are totally dry.
Well, we have to get some water balloons and get them. Well, listen, you two did an excellent job. Hey, we're going to see you later on. We hope you had fun watching these two. We have winners right here.
Woo! And now a look at the United Cerebral Palsy Association.
Well, Cassie is... Cassie gets frustrated sometimes because she can't do everything everybody does, but
right.
That doesn't stop her from trying, and that's the most important thing.
She's very motivated.
She's very motivated.
There's actually nothing she can't do. I mean, she is so independent that she goes potty by herself. She's been doing that for a long time. She attempts everything. She does everything other children do. She just had a little hard time doing it, but she does
right.
it. And her desire of getting something done, I mean, she's going to go full force. I mean, we know. It wouldn't surprise me that she will get a gymnastics or something
right,
like that.
Right.
Because, I mean, she is just incredible. She's actually a miracle baby.
In fact, just a couple of weeks ago, she was roller skating in her walker.
Uh-huh.
There are degrees of CP, there's no question about it. And in her case, we're very fortunate that it's mild. The primary effects of the CP in
right.
Cassie's case affect her motor system and her legs and her walking. And there have been so many advances, fortunately, in medical technology that they can
right.
they can now do wondrous things to
a lot more things than they used to
yes.
years ago.
Right. Yeah. Fortunately, she doesn't have anything mentally.
Yeah.
She's extremely bright.
She's very bright.
She has a
very
computer
early.
Brain. Actually, her teacher tells us that there's nothing she forgets. I mean, she memorizes everything.
All right. Well, I hear you guys have an amazing story about how you got your daughter.
We had a phone call one time. We were ready to go out for dinner, and the social workers called us. And she came, and 2 weeks went, 2 months went, and 2 years went. Cassie stayed with us, and we adopted her just last January.
She seems like a very lively and very outgoing little girl.
She, like you say, she is a love, and to us, she's pretty close to perfect.
We'll be back to Universal Studios Hollywood, where we promise you'll have a really swinging time.
In our next event, Knowing the Ropes, each team has four members. The first pulls a raft along a rope. The second rides a slide for life. The third boogies up a rope cargo net. And the last one has to cross a rope bridge. Here's Brian.
Okay, we're here with Chris, and now your team came in last event. Are you feeling a little intimidated, maybe a little pressure?
No, we're going to take care of that this time. We're going to get in first.
Well, of course, you're in the water. He was talking about he's surfing and all that stuff. So let's see how well you surf on this little raft here. All right? Good luck.
Okay, dudes, we're back at the Miami Vice stunt show, and the Fuchsia team's the first one in the water. There's the gun.
And there's Christopher Pettit. What I want to know is, how come he's the only person not wearing a wetsuit?
He's not afraid of the water.
No, it's his surfing style. He's a surfer.
No, his dog's ate it. He's got a rat terrier. They chewed it up.
Rat terrier.
Okay. Look at him motor through the water, guys. He's going to get across quick. Now raise that bell, and here comes A.J. Langer on the slide for life.
Now, as she lets go, she's got to hit a styrofoam target in the water.
Wow, that's right. Perfect shot. Oh, on the board, into the water, Angela Watson, a step-by-step. Now, she's got a very tough part of this. She has to do this to climb up a cargo net. And she's not that easy, right, Bob?
No, that's very difficult. Not that I've ever done it before. People have talked to her, told me it's very difficult.
Arguably, the most demanding part of this event is getting out of the water and up that net. Look at her struggle with it.
Well, her hair is all wet. Look how heavy it is.
That's got to wear down by 3 or 4 pounds right there.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying.
And now she's got to get to the top of this net and connect with Darius, right?
That's right.
And he finishes the race. There he goes.
There's the tag.
He's going to work his way across the lagoon.
Oh!
Darius.
Oh, careful, buddy.
He's a cross queen.
Some people do anything to win.
Watch that replay, guys. Look at him. That is a daring young man. Let's go to Scott with the Fuchsia team.
Congratulations. That was a pretty good run out here. How's the water?
Oh, it's great. Everything's cold.
Feels good. I was cold. I got a few questions, buddy. I was cold. I fell. I got to recover.
So I just say, Scotty, rolling.
Well, you did a good job.
I was playing. I didn't fall. No.
All right, guys. Let's see if you get everybody else.
Okay, Joey, now your team came in third in the last competition, right?
Yeah.
Third place. So what are you hoping to do here? I mean, Chris really did a good
great
time
job on
rope,
this.
So.
I know.
A little pressure there?
Yeah,
a little
definitely.
About it.
Sure, you know, because if you fall off, then you make a fool of yourself. So I hope that
I wouldn't
fall off.
I wouldn't worry about that.
All right.
Take care, Joey.
First on the wrap for the blue team, Joey Lawrence. Quite a competitor, and unlike our first runner, he's got a wetsuit on, Bob. What do you think?
Well, he may be afraid of falling in. You can see he's competing a lot more methodically than Christopher was.
Yeah, he just wants to look good.
And he does.
You think he pumped up this morning?
Oh, easy,
so.
Rain. Look at that. Come on, Rain, now. Okay, he's got to get off this baby, get up there and ring a bell, right?
That's right. Corey Carey is going to be described for life. Here he goes.
Look at young Indy. Can he hit the target?
Oh, he just got a piece of that target, Alex.
Josh Saviano of the Wonder Years into the water. This is the most difficult part of the event, wouldn't you say?
Well, I think the fact that coupled with he's propelling himself with his leg muscles on the board and then having to use the legs to climb that cargo net, it really does take its toll.
Yeah, this is probably where this race is going to be won or lost right here.
Yeah, look at him working his way up the net. That is a tough, tough thing to do.
He's got to touch Olivia Burnett. And here she goes. Let's see how she does.
Olivia trying to negotiate her way to the end of the course in good time. Oh, she's got a slip. Will she hit the water or will she make it across? Oh, she's in the water.
Good thing she's got that wetsuit on, Bob.
Yeah.
Watch the replay. Look at her lose her grip and straight down into the drink, guys. Unbelievable.
Oh, my God.
You were going over
there. I fell.
You were going very well up until the very end.
I was doing so good.
Yes.
I don't know what happened. I like slipped or something. And all I know is it's very, very
cold. It's cold?
Cold.
All right, go get a towel. Thank you. It is cold. We'll find out what the time was. Good luck to you. All right. 1:12. Whoa.
Okay, Haley, now the blue team, who was just up, they pulled themselves into the lead because they had a very fast time going across, a lot faster than the first team. So do you think you picked up any little tools you might use this time?
Probably. I mean, I'm not really sure how I'm going to do it because I've never done it before. But I'm probably, going to pull the rope so I can get a little speed faster.
Well, it sounds like a plan to me. Good luck with it. Hope it works out for you.
Thanks.
Okay, guys, first into the water for the Aqua Acrobat, Haley Johnson, sitting in a lotus kind of position. What do you suppose that's all about?
I think women's center of gravity seems to be in their hips, and I think that's a great place for her to be.
She's making good time getting across the water. Now, when she gets to the other side, she's going to have to work her way up this ramp and ring a bell. And
she's having a problem right here, Alex.
That's right. Look at her. She's going to get the Brandon call. Guys, did you know Brandon started his career as a six-year-old Elvis impersonator?
I bless the master, the world's wrong
with him. And the king is with us. Look at him kick.
He's sliding like a man on a jungle jet.
Not quite onto the target. Mario into the water.
Just that surfing style.
He seems to not be one with the board, however, and has lost it completely. He's in the water and now again on the treacherous cargo net.
Yeah, I think he'll do okay here, though, because he's a strong kid.
Everyone seems to be having a hard time with that cargo
net. He almost missed the net. almost off the side. Who is this coming across now, guys?
Carol Ann Plante.
Carol Ann showing great coordination and balance. Unbelievably difficult with those sharks underneath in the water.
Sharks? Who's thinking about sharks?
On the replay, you can see the young Elvis kicking and screaming.
He's in the water. He's all wet.
Let's go to Scott.
You've done that before, haven't you?
No, I practiced on the highway or what?
That was incredible. You guys did very well.
Do you know what I'm talking about?
No, I do not, but we'll have to wait and see. Congratulations, that was terrific.
Thank you so much. The Aqua Teen's time was 1:12.9, which puts them into second place for this event.
Easter Steels is still in the lead, though.
Okay, Mark Ball, now, look, the blue team is still in the lead on this event. I noticed, though, you had good tactics in the first event.
That's right.
In the boat. Everyone seemed to complain, but yeah, good. Now, do you have anything special that you think you're going to try and pull off here?
Well, I'm going to try every little possible thing to gain our time. Everything is just going to be on a pinpoint thing, so when I make it over there, just a split second, they're going to be over there. So we're just going to rip through this course. Hopefully, we'll win.
Seems to be very smart in what he's doing. We'll see. We'll see how it works out, Mark.
Okay, guys, on the raft for the Coral Crusaders, Mark Paul Gosselaar, saved by the bell.
Yeah, and Bob almost went over there because he's a little too tall in the saddle, I think.
Yeah, he's probably the largest competitor I think we have here.
He's up on his knees, which gives him great speed, but his balance seems to be off as he gets to the end of the dock.
Hit the bell, let's go.
Good transition.
Very fast.
Go, 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 go.
He hits the bell, and who's up?
Danny Pintar, from Who's the Boss.
Nice puck position. Will he hit the mark?
Right.
Good job. Into the water on the board.
Mayim Bialik.
Mayim Bialik. Blossom herself has been given the most difficult part of this course. Guys, how do you think she's going to do getting through the water?
She's really hard.
She had a great running start off that platform also, which helped her.
Yeah, but here's that cargo net. It's tied up other people. Let's see how Mayim does with it.
She seems to have a hold on this cargo net.
Now she's touched silver, Gregory. And here comes the final leg.
One more chance to get into the water. Silver Gregory, nice balance, trying to get across, make some time.
Oh! There's the water for Silver Gregory.
Oh, good thing she had that wetsuit on, huh, Bob?
I don't think she's... There she goes.
Once again, the wetsuit does the trick. She's getting across. She makes the edge. Let's watch on the replay. First her feet, then her hands, then everything into the drink. Get a towel ready, guys, and let's go to Scott.
I think you guys did okay, though. I think we did pretty good.
You had a
good
time going until you fell off.
Well, we're going to tally it all and see what's going on, so good luck to you. All right.
A look at the score shows us that with winning the event, the Easter Seals team has increased their lead over the Aqua team, with Coral and Fuchsia tied for third.
And now some health and fitness tips from Mr. Universe, Joe DeAngelis.
A lot of the competitions in this show require that the participants be in great shape if they want to do well. But what is being in shape? It means having a strong heart, having strong muscles, and being lean. And the way you get these things is through a good aerobics program, like walking or riding your bike, a good weight training program, and by being on a good nutrition program and being sure to avoid lots of junk food.
Well, thank you, Joe. Well, we'll be back to Universal Studios Hollywood in a moment for some electronic fun and games.
And we're back at Universal Studios Hollywood with the Sega Star Kids Challenge. Here is Rain Fryer.
We're in the Parisian courtyard here at Universal Studios Hollywood. As you can see, everything is very, very French, very continental, and very sophisticated.
Bonjour, mademoiselle. How are you today? Are you enjoying a lovely little courtyard, will you know?
Oui, oui.
Well, she speaks French too, eh? I can introduce you to my very famous friend here, Monsieur Sonic the Hedgehog.
Shouldn't we just be explaining the next event, Monsieur Scott?
But of course, and tell me, how are you with the computer game?
I think I can hold my own, thank you.
Such funny expressions.
these crazy Americans have. Well, indeed, this is a tag game. It's a very tough one. His name, that's my very good friend here, Mr. Sonic the Hedgehog.
Just tell him how it works, Scott.
Fine. Can I do it in English?
Yes.
Thank you. There will be three video players from each team. They each play the game for 1 minute and then hand off to the next team member.
And the winners will be determined by cumulative team points.
Now we, but of course.
We.
I'm here with part of the Easter Seals team, the blue team, and now you guys won one event in Florida and then the one you just had, so you guys are in the lead. But how many people here have actually played Sonic and know they can excel in this? This is a tough event.
Well, we've all,
here
we've
are,
all played. Yeah, I think Corey's got the advantage.
And then comes Josh.
And then me, and then comes Joe.
Yeah, I'm the last. I'm the low guy in the total pole.
Okay, well, the low guy can always help out. So hopefully you guys will pull it through and stay in first.
If we win this one, then we're going to have a big, big lead, and then we're never going to let it go.
That sounds good.
Let's hope for it, guys. Good luck.
In our video portion of the games here with Sonic the Hedgehog, concentration is going to be the critical element, guys.
Josh Byrne there with his own individual style. Yeah, he's
talking.
There's
Haley Johnson.
Kind of chewing on the lip type of concentration.
Oh, she got the hat back, but she's serious.
Angela Watson is step by step. She is into the game, guys. You can see the blue team from Easter Seals are all with Corey Carrier as he tackles the machine. Each team will send three competitors to the line for 1 minute of time on the machine. At the end of that time, the team who has compiled the most points will be declared the winner. As you see Sonic the Hedgehog battling his way through various obstacles.
Well, he's a pretty agile individual, isn't he?
The most athletic competitor we have here today may be Sonic the Hedgehog.
Don't tell the kids you hurt their feelings.
Look at the concentration on these kids. Look at them. They mean business in this game, guys.
As Sonic continues along the course, picking up rings and avoiding obstacles.
There's our first changeover.
Matthew Lawrence of Make-A-Wish, Coral Team.
And Bobby, notice something about these competitors in this event?
Yeah, you know, none of them were wearing wetsuits as they were in the previous event.
Why is that?
Oh, well, they're on dry land.
Chelsea Hertford of Major Dad needs no wetsuit. She just needs those controls in her hand. Look at her go.
Very serious. You know, it's interesting the different styles they have, Alex, you know, of concentration.
Yeah, Josh Saviano has his hat around, his eyes are glued to the set. Look at him go. Matthew Lawrence almost loses his hat. He is so into this game.
For Chelsea Hertford for Mad Mothers Against Drunk Driving.
We're coming up on our next competitor change as Chris Pettit tries to get as many points as possible before he has to pass off. Once again, the blue team showing that kind of concentration, working hard, supporting their people. All right, here's that third change.
Mouse Paul chooses to wear the shades. I don't know if that's going to help him or hurt him.
He's got a bright future. Look at Terrence Smith with the tongue action. This kid's been watching Michael Jordan too much. Look at him attack that machine.
Darius McCary.
Got Charlie Chaplin helping him out.
How can you lose to Charlie Chaplin behind you, huh? There's our other Lawrence.
Joey
Lawrence
being yelled at by Josh Saviano about the game.
These guys are into it. They need a coach and a trainer. Maya Bialik showing Mark Paul the way.
Oh, Mark just had a little problem there.
The whole aqua team behind Taryn.
Darius McCrary showing the kind of concentration necessary to win this event. And look at the blue team, Josh showing Joey the way. Look at him, he's tearing his nails off, he's so into it. And the blue team comes out on top, unbelievable. The Easter Seals team just keeps racking up points. Let's go to rain with the winners.
This is the third win for the blue team. Tell me, how do you feel? Yeah! And what was your strategy?
To get as many points as
possible. Well, just to get as many points as possible and go as fast as we can. He did everything here.
Well,
there you have it again for the third win in the row, the blue team.
And now let's take a little visit with Josh Saviano at home.
Tenemos fotografías aquí, dibujos aquí.
¿Cómo se llama él?
Teatro Metropolitano.
Correcto, es un teatro y hay un concierto que tiene lugar aquí, pero ¿cómo se llama este cantante al centro?
Se llama Mick Jagger.
Mick Jagger, correcto.
I have a private studio teacher come to set every day. We actually have a few of them, one who specializes in English and history and languages, and another who specializes in math and science. And I'm enrolled in school in New Jersey, and we send via Federal Express back and forth work. And my teachers, they intercept the work here, they look at it, see what needs to be taught, teach it to me, I do the work, and we send it back. And it's so far it's been working rather well. Anything that involves a running around and a some sort of moving object, I like. I love all sorts of sports, both to play and to watch. A lot of people, although now in Los Angeles it's becoming to be a really big sport, is hockey. I've always found hockey I've loved watching hockey the best. I've always been an enormous New York Ranger fan. My dream has always been to be as successful in this business as I can be. And then afterwards, when I've established myself and I'm a household name, I give something back to society. And, you know, I open up a playhouse where anyone can come in and act and for free, and we'll give them stuff like that, you know, give them small salaries here or there, go on the road, have concerts, just have everything that I always wanted to have, like a little boy dreams of.
We'll be right back from Florida with some wild, wild stunts. Welcome back to Universal Studios Florida and the Wild, Wild West Stunt Show. Come on down to Florida and see these wranglers. Watch them rope and fight and kick, and it's all in good fun, but it's quite a wild show, as you can see.
Universal Studios Florida at the Wild, 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 Wild West Stunt Show, and one of the biggest attractions here. And right now, our Sega Star kids are doing something that I think every kid would want to do, and that's learn how to do some stunts. You know, actually, I think every adult would like to learn how to do some stunts. You know, I think I have some time. I think I'll go learn how to do some stunts. Let's go check it out.
The stuntmen showed the kids how to take a punch, but our guys didn't just learn how to take it. They soon found ways to dish it out.
I was over there practicing how to do punches, and there they just hit a box over my head.
It's fun. Ashley Levitch from All Fly Away was ready to do just that.
So we're learning like a lot of stuff. The stunt guys are teaching us how to jump on the trampoline and get hit over the head with a bottles and crates and everything, and we'll survive, hopefully.
And it's a good thing these growing pains that Jeremy Miller gave the stuntman weren't for real.
And now, how about a hard-hitting profile of star kid Jeremy Miller?
Man, to work on growing pains was always a blast, you know? Everybody was always horse around. You know, when it was time to work, we worked. But when it was time to play, man, did we play. We all had an absolute blast. You know, it was a great cast and great crew, so it made everything a lot easier.
Well, now that you've completed the last growing pain, how does it feel?
A little bit of a relief, you know, being able to move on, but it was hard to tape that last show, real hard.
What kind of plans are in the future for Jeremy Miller?
Well, hopefully I'll go on to some other stuff, you know, maybe a movie or two, whatever comes up, you know.
I understand, Jeremy, that you're very involved in some things that impact kids your own age. Can you tell us about that?
Well, I work with some educational groups is my main thing, education and literacy. And I'm the founder of a group called Club Ed, which is me and six other kids who are on TV, and we go around the country talking to kids in schools about education and stuff and learning to read. And sometimes we'll bring scripts from our own show, and whoever can read comes up and reads them with us.
Back at the Wild Wild West show, the kids all got together and decided to pool their talents so they could show their stunt teachers some of the new tricks. Jill Setter, a welcome freshman, showed everyone she was a big hit with a stunt box. And David
David Roden from the same show proved he could be a smash with a fake bottle. Maybe the stuntmen taught these guys too well.
Boy, those stuntmen were really amazing. I mean, they all make it look so incredibly real. Now, let's go out for a conversation with our big...
And now, let's look at a pair of star kids who have a very special friendship. Ashley Levitch and Jenna Von Oy.
Well, even though I'm from Connecticut and she's from Georgia, and we work in And even though she works in Georgia and I work in Hollywood, we've met each other through the NBC press tour because we're both on the same channel. Well, you know, it was the NBC press tour, so I'm sure they kind of figured that out. But anyway, so we met each other at this press party that they had in the beginning of the year, and we didn't know each other real well, you know. But yeah, and then we saw each other at an event that we did not too long ago, and it was promoting Earth Trust, and they did an album, and it was about 100 celebrity kids there, and
now we see each other when we do appearances in the same city, or every once in a while go out to LA and we'll go shopping. And
we talk to each other on the phone at least twice a week and spend our parents' phone bill.
Yes, at least twice a
week. And we have fun doing it too. Yeah.
Spend all their hard-earned money.
Yeah.
Tell me about this dream of yours.
To be able to be in the same city for more than two days.
We never get to see each other that much because, you know, working in different states. I mean, we talk to each other all the time, but
our schedules are so nuts.
But we don't get to see each other that often. Yeah. So
our goal is to have like more than 2 days together in the same city.
To spend shopping. And checking out guys.
Yes.
Don't tell my mom I said that. Anyway.
So that's our like dream. We'll do it sometime.
Yeah, we will.
Maybe this
summer. I'm sure it'll happen.
Yeah.
She wants me to come to Georgia, but I don't know if I can do it.
Yeah, well, I'm going to come visit you in LA when you go up there.
That's right.
Yeah.
Okay, now, I understand there's a whole singing thing between you.
Yes. When we were doing the Earth Day thing, we discovered that each other had good voices, and we started singing, and we ended up,
singing
both being in the same group, and they asked us, whether we wanted to be soprano or alto or whatever we wanted to be, and we went, yes, at the same time. It was funny. And we always sing. I mean, we sing in the car, and we sing everything.
Always.
Wherever we go,
we're singing.
Then?
He wants us to sing. Okay.
What?
Sometimes the snow comes down in June. Sometimes the sun goes round the moon. I see the passion in your eyes. Sometimes it's all the big surprise. There was a time when all I did was wish you tell me this was love. It's not the way I hoped or how I planned, but somehow it's enough. And now we're standing face to face. Isn't this world a crazy place? Just when I thought a chance had passed, you go and save the last for last.
And on that note, we'll take a break and be right back to Universal Studios Hollywood for some straight-up competition.
Welcome back to the Sega Star Kids Challenge, being brought to you by Sega, leading the 16-bit revolution with Genesis, and by Jolly Rancher Candy, the great taste of fruit squared. Here are Scott and Bob.
We're back at Universal Studios Hollywood with our commissioner, Bob Golick. Now, Bob, the contest has been pretty tough so far. Does this next event give these young people any time to breathe at all?
No way, Scott. No, in fact, this next event will have them climbing the walls.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
All right, commissioner, hit me with the rules and regs.
Well, Scott, they're pretty straightforward. Do we have three guys per team? Two teams will run head-to-head. Each player has to climb the wall using the handholds to get to the top. Now, when they get there, they jump off into a pit bag and run back to the start where they tag off to the next runner. The winner of each heat will go into a final.
U-G-L-Y, you ain't got no alibi, you hug me. Yeah, yeah, you hug me.
Next up for our competitors, the treacherous wall. Two teams, two heats. The winning team in each heat will meet the other for the championship. We start with Fuchsia and Aqua.
Now, the thing we got to tell the people here is that prior to this race, both the wall and the bottoms of the competitors' shoes were done over with a spray wax.
Well, and Brandon Collis, step by step, ignored it. He just went to the top and over.
Christopher Pettit finishing up for the Fuchsia team.
Darius McCrary doesn't care what's on him. He's going up and over without using anything.
Look at him. Is this kid an athlete?
Over.
And there's poor Nicole Dubik. She's look at the technique there. She's trying everything to get up that hill.
Guys, you know you tried this earlier today, and this is not a simple event for anybody, let alone girls in pads and gloves.
You have strength for this thing, Alex.
I myself would have tried, but well.
Candace Hudson on the Fuchsia team. Yeah, she's making a slow way. She's making her way very slowly, but catching up to Nicole.
All she has to do is get over the wall, and she's done just about.
Now watch Candace. Look at her.
She's being very careful coming over.
Candace, it's a big pad. Go ahead and jump.
There you go.
But she hit that X right dead on.
Perfect spot. That's Fuchsia has finished. Now Mario Lopez will have to play Superman to get back in it.
I like to see him and Darius go head to head.
That would be a good race. Yeah, that's a little too late for Mario, but a good run.
Yeah. Super run by Mario. Let's watch this replay, you guys. You can see where the win came. The Fuchsia team wins on the strength of Darius McCrary's legs. Let's go to range.
You kind of flew over there. How did you do it?
I don't know. I just thought of Batman. And I was like, oh, God.
You were the running man. What kind of pressure did that put?
Well, I didn't do it as well as I wanted to, but I'm going to do it better next time.
Well, you look good to me. And congratulations, guys.
Up next, the Coral and Blue team. There is Josh Saviano of the Wonder Years and Brittany Murphy of Drexel's class ready to attack the wall.
Let's see if anybody learned anything from Darius on this.
Josh seems to have a way with the wall. Oh, maybe not. He's over and into the pad. Off to teammate Joey Lawrence, another big guy. These big guys get over the wall in rapid time. Look at them. And there's Mayim Bialik, Blossom herself for the Coral team, battling up the wall.
And Joey Lawrence coming around and giving it to the last leg.
Hangs off to Jody Sweeten from Full House.
Mayim into the pads. This is going to set up a rundown.
Yeah, this is going to be close right here.
Oh!
And Jody Sweeten having a real... Oh, there she goes, back down the wall.
Oh, my. Jody takes the big slide as Mark Paul comes around to take the victory. The Coral team will watch Jody Sweeten try to slide her way back up that hill. Look at her.
She's determined to finish, Alex.
You don't think that wall is frustrating? Just look at the look at her face. But look at the determination.
What a
She's going to get up there.
She is pulling herself.
What a competitor. This kid is a winner in every sense of the word. Come on, Jody. You can do it.
Well, she has just figured out the toes and the foothold technique. So.
I think she just figured out that we whacked that sucker down before we started, too.
She thought we just wanted to keep it, like, real clean. But
there she goes.
Come on. She's going to make it to the top. There you go.
All right, Jody.
Let's give her some credit for that. That was difficult.
Outstanding. Jody Sweeten of the East.
She made it.
And she recognizes her own effort there.
Outstanding.
Great job.
Gotta give the go-ahead.
You can see the camaraderie amongst all the competitors as Danny Pintaro from the Make-A-Wish team goes over to congratulate her.
She's tired. Watch the replay, guys. We're going to see the agony and the ecstasy. Look at Jody as she slides all the way back down the hill. And then as she makes it to the top and lets everybody know what winning's all about.
And as they prepare for the final, let's get another tip on health and fitness from Mr. Universe, Joe DeAngelis.
A great way to make your muscles toned and strong is to use progressive resistance exercise. Progressive resistance exercise is any exercise you can make harder. It might be calisthenics, weight training, or even exercise machines. As the exercise gets easier, you should do what you can to make it harder. That way there, your body will grow even stronger.
Hang in there. We'll be right back with the cliffhanger conclusion of
The Wall.
And we're back at Universal Studios Hollywood. It is Bob Golic on the wall. We're going to come back to the final heat in this event. But first, let's take a moment out to meet our two Johnson sisters, Haley and Ashley.
Time to bring on some changes and restore some peace of mind.
And I want to be an executive producer and writer. Well, when I first got started in the business was when I first did this commercial for, it was for this doctor's office thing for a funny show. And I had to be having chicken pox that were painted on me. And like 2 days or 3 days later, I got the chicken pox and I thought I got it from them. And that's when I started acting. A whole great thing. And we get to record music and do music on different kinds of tracks and record our vocals. It's really fun to see how it all turns out. And then, like, on the keyboard and stuff, there's, like, different sounds on it. Like, from the sea, there's also, like, a rap thing. It's really funny.
At the final of the wall, you see the Coral team and the Future team getting ready. It's going to be a big battle, a lot of points at stake. There's Brittany Murphy of Drexel's class, Christopher Pettit of the Young Riders. They will lead off here.
Now, the one thing they did do here is they re-waxed the wall because they felt that some of the bigger competitors were having a little bit too easy a time.
You could tell he just tried to run up and over and he slipped and had to use the handhold.
They are having all kinds of trouble, and Brittany is all the way back down. Oh, what a bad break for the Coral team.
Looks like they whacked Brittany, too.
Yeah. Look at Darius. He's trying to attack it again.
Not as easy as the first time.
No, they put a lot of wax in that wall and their shoes.
Well, they saw him run up it so fast last time. And Brittany Murphy climbs the wall twice for her team, finally getting around the corner to get to her teammate. Maya Bialik hits the wall, and she finds it a slippery go again.
And Candace Hudson is pulling up that wall, toe in the slot.
Now, Candace is the last competitor for the Future team, so...
Yeah, that was it.
They've got a little bit of a lead here.
So if she doesn't slide down, I think they're going to win it.
I think she's going to make it. Look at her.
They reach the top together. We'll get our first double jump of the day, guys.
Whoa,
nice jump.
And this is going to be the end for the Future team.
That's right. They're done.
United Cerebral Palsy wins the event. The Coral team with Mark Paul Gosselaar, the last competitor.
The Coral team is for Make-A-Wish.
He wishes he'd had a better time in this event.
It was their first leg that when Brittany slid down, that was the problem.
Yeah, let's watch the replay. That's going to show us exactly where it all came from.
Yeah, this is where it is, Alex.
All the way down to the bottom.
Look
no the, way they could make
look
that
Look at that
up.
Frustration.
Let's go to Rain.
That was good, baby. They made it a little more slicker. I tried to do the same move last time, and I almost fell on my butt. I had to watch them.
It was a lot slicker this time. On the way back, running down here, I was like almost sliding past the...
Get this little one some credit here.
How did you do it?
I have no idea. My eyes were closed the whole way.
And with that victory, the Fuchsia team moves into a tie for second place with the Coral team. But it's still the Blue team at first.
And now let's see what happened when a young lady made a wish, which was heard by the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
Make-A-Wish is really a good company. It was a wonderful idea, and I made a wish. It came true, and I think that's wonderful because when you're sick, you look for something bright every day, and they're just so wonderful.
Originally, all she asked for was an invitation to the ball, and she's ended up as Cinderella. And I think she's going to have a wonderful time.
We're just going to have a wonderful time. When I first heard about it, I just began to become sick, and I never thought I was sick enough, because there are much sicker people than I, and I thought, well, I don't really deserve this, and a couple years passed, and I was still sick,
started to get a little down, thinking, I don't want to be sick anymore. And then I thought, Make-A-Wish. And I remembered I really liked 90210, and Brian Austin Green's my favorite character. Thought, wouldn't it be fun to meet him?
So what are we walking somewhere? Can we go in the back and hang out? On it, Universal Studios, Hollywood. I like that.
Los Angeles in the 40s, New York in the 50s, or London.
Catch that. How crazy is that? This is all brand new, but it looks old, doesn't it? Looks old, doesn't it?
Very old. That's it.
Silver linings back in class.
And we are cheerfully back at Universal Studios Hollywood for the Sega Star Kids Challenge.
And they're getting ready for the finals of the Paris Street Fitness Race. To catch up on what happened here earlier, let's go up to Alex.
Well, thank you, Scott. In Heat 1, it was the blue team that won when Aqua had problems at the crash pad. And then Carol Ann Plante seemed to get tangled up in the jump rope. In Heat 2, Coral went on to the victory despite the fact that Josh Byrne got a little lost. As a matter of fact, so did Ashley Johnson.
And now let's take a look at the important work of Mothers Against Drunk Driving.
Well, my daughter, Alexandra Vincent, was driving on the freeway and her car broke down and she pulled onto the shoulder and called me and I went to pick her up. And as we were there on the shoulder of the freeway, a drunk driver came along 55 to 60 miles an hour driving on the shoulder. He didn't know. He couldn't tell because of the alcohol in the system that he was driving on the shoulder of the freeway. He couldn't tell that the cars were stopped and not moving, and he couldn't tell that the lights were flashing and not steady. And he hit the car that my daughter Alex was leaning into to get her AAA card out of, going 55 miles an hour. And she was thrown about 21 feet, and her neck was completely shattered, and she died there on the shoulder of the freeway in my arms.
You have an opportunity, you know, with a tragedy like this. You have two paths you can go. You are a victim, but you can remain in a victim mode, or you can decide, well, I want it to mean something. I want to do something to help, to see that other people don't have to go through the same thing that I did.
MAD's mission is to stop drunk driving and to aid the victims of this heinous crime. In many states, when we first began, drunk driving was not even a crime. I mean, here we had people that were put into vehicles. They were behind the wheel driving 2,000, 3,000, and 4,000-pound automobiles with weapons that were maiming and crippling and killing people. We had more than 600,000 people a year that were being maimed and killed, and more than 28,000 people a year that we knew of back in that day and time in the early 80s, 1980, that were being killed due to drinking and driving. So today what we're doing is, what MAD has really done is we have affected change in the public's attitude and their behavior. The behavior is slow in coming, but attitudes have years ago. I mean, how many of us could go into work and someone at work at the office would say, oh, I was so drunk last night, I don't know how I got home. People would laugh. Today, they don't laugh. It's not funny anymore. There are too many alternatives out there. It's a crime today.
And now let's go to Scott at the starting line with Joey Lawrence and Danny Pintaro.
All right, gentlemen, this is the finals. You a little nervous?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah?
Yeah, definitely.
It's hard, yeah. But
what do you think? What's the hardest part of the course?
I think this is probably the hardest. It's hard to get through. There's a lot of stuff to get in your way.
Yeah.
What part of it is the hardest for you?
Going through those things right there. Last time I went through, I totally...
They're really low, you know, and you have to, like, almost get down and just use your arms, which
I
is...
I want this guy. There's this really hefty guy over there. I want him to do the pull-ups for me, and then we'll tag off, and then I'll go.
If you want that, I guess you can do it.
Why not? That's
right.
Guys, good luck.
All right, thanks.
All right. Okay. May the best team win. And see you at the end.
All right.
So here we are at the final heat of the fitness relay. Danny Pintaro, Joey Lawrence, ready to pull up and get going.
Now they're doing 5 pull-ups here.
And they seem to be breaking out pretty even. Joey's away, and Danny has stopped. Apparently, he did not chin up enough.
And now looking for a ruling.
It's going to cost them a lot of time. The blue team is not hesitating.
And Corey Carrot is flying through this course.
Watch him throw his body down there to reach Josh Saviano as he jams onto those sit-ups.
And Josh Burt has quite a bit of time to make up here, desperately trying to get through those cones.
I don't know if Coral can catch him. Look at him hit the pad. Josh Saviano trying to reach Kelly Martin for the last leg of this all-important fitness relay.
And Matthew Lawrence working hard.
And Kelly Martin gets to those jump ropes and coming to the end of the race.
That's it.
That's the T from Easterseals.
That is
victory.
The winner. Right there, Kelly Martin hits the pad for the victory. The Make-A-Wish team trying to make up time, but it's all for naught at this point. Mark Paul looking outstanding. Oh, nice talk.
Doing a half gainer.
Yeah, that's
that.
Easy, a 5-9 from the East German judge as he crashes through the padding. Let's go down to Brian.
The agony of defeat, Mark Paul. Mark Paul.
What?
What was the biggest holdup in the course? While you're laying here.
I don't know. I wasn't the biggest holdup in the course.
Oh. I'm just kidding. We'll win the next
one. See, this is a serious thing. It's taken very seriously. There's no joking here. No joking. Kelly. Guys, blue team. Good race. Good race. Now, after 6 events, you guys are still in first place.
That's right, baby.
Well, hey, gonna try and keep it that way.
You better believe it. You're still going all the way.
All the way, blue team. You heard it straight from them. They're going to take it all the way. Good luck, guys.
All right,
Commissioner, what happened at the beginning?
Well, a completed pull-up includes having the chin go over the bar. You see, Danny didn't complete it on the last one. Was forced to go back and complete the pull-up.
With that victory, the blue takes a commanding lead, followed by Coral, which is moving to second by itself, and tied for third is Aqua and Fuchsia. And now sit back and get ready for another Star Kids home movie.
I know.
Having fun? Well, we'll be back in a moment with the Waiter's Race. We're back with the Sega Star Kids Challenge.
Welcome back to Universal Studios Hollywood, where we're on the Star Walk, and we're just about to start the infamous Waiter's Race.
Mr. Scott, this event is enough to make your head spin, and in fact, I think it has.
I think so too, Rain. Matt. But this event does tend to make the competitors very busy. You want to let the folks at home know how these work?
Even better. Our commissioner has agreed to demonstrate this event in his new bum attire.
Great. Time for a little show and tell, as you crazy Americans say. Okay, there are 4 competitors per team, and all 4 teams compete at once.
Each participant must run to a pylon, put their head down on it, and then run around it 5 times.
That is the killer. After that, each competitor runs. That is, if they can find the right direction.
To a table where they have to fill up some champagne glasses on a tray.
Then they must take those glasses to another table where they empty them out into a container.
While trying not to spill all the liquid.
Right. Then they must run back to the start line and touch off to the next runner.
And the team with the most water in the container wins.
Yes, but in the event of a tie, the team with the best time wins. Enough of this, Mr. Scott, already. I'm fed up. This accent's making me dizzy.
Well, it's making me dizzy,
yeah,
too, Scott.
No kidding.
Speaking of which, thanks for the demo, Bob.
Yeah, Bob. Now let's go over to Brian Green and see if our competitors are ready.
Okay, here we are with all 4 teams, and
Guys, what do you think is going to be the hardest part of this whole obstacle? Is it the head spin or the water?
I'm going to get dizzy. I'm going to get so
dizzy. It's going to be
fun. But see, I did this last year, so I'm experienced, so I know what to do.
Oh, he's a big stud.
So basically, it's an overall hard event. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
You think one of the toughest, or?
Definitely.
Yeah, I don't know if it's
challenging, I'll say.
Yeah. It's the most challenging.
Okay, well, good luck, you guys. I got to see this dizziness.
And look at that, boys and girls. Bullwinkle's here to start the race for us.
Hey, Rocky.
Maybe the big moose doesn't know it. This is a tough event. The kids have to spin around five times. As Tiffany Amber Thiessen from Saved by the Bell doing her spin.
Kids Incorporated, Haley Johnson being very deliberate about what she's doing.
Danny Pintaro, our only returning veteran from this event.
Now as they run down to the tables with a glass. Oh, Tiffany's had a little problem.
So we have A.J. Langer filling up her glasses very carefully.
Interesting technique here by Tiffany, putting the glasses on the tray before filling them.
Obviously, some waitressing experience in her past.
Haley Johnson doesn't want to spill a drop of that water.
Danny Pintaro breaks from the pack early and heads for the table.
There's Tiffany Amber again making her way. Very deliberate.
They now dump the glasses into a pitcher, return the tray, run down and touch their
AJ
partner.
AJ Langer is in third place at this moment. Going a little slow.
And Danny Pintaro, the coral team, is the first one back. Silver Gregory now spinning around.
Now Tiffany finishing up her first leg. Corey Carrier. We taking up the second leg
the
for the
Blues. The future team is third.
And I don't think Haley Johnson has gotten back yet.
Now she's taking her time.
Yeah. There she goes. Now she's getting back.
There's Corey, a little messy. No, he won't work in a restaurant.
And coming up is Angela Watson for the Fuchsia team representing UCP.
Guys, I may be crazy, but I don't think there's going to be enough water here. Look at him spill that stuff.
Corey dumping his glasses.
And Brandon Cole, almost falling into the crowd. He's so dizzy.
Water everywhere on this
court. Corey forgot his glasses. He's going to get back and get those and get them to the first table. It's going to cost him a lot of time here.
Angela Watson's now up. She is dumping the water in that bucket real fast.
This race is going to go down to the wire as Silver Gregory touches off to her teammate Brittany Murphy.
And Corey Carrier tags off to Olivia Burnett.
Angela Watson tosses off to Darius McCrary.
And Brandon Cole still with the drinks out at the other end.
Okay, Brittany Murphy cleanly across the barriers and now she's at the table.
Maybe Burnett making her way down the lane to the water, just a little off kilter.
Darius, high concentration on his face.
And Brandon Cole just getting back to Mario Lopez, who takes off.
Mario once played a gang member in the movie Colors. He's going to need to spin like crazy to get back in this one. There's Maya Bialik. She's back on the court.
And Olivia Burnett emptying her glasses into the pail, also emptying her tray in. A little strange technique.
Same with Darius McCrary.
I don't know if emptying the tray is going to win it, but they're going to have to move awful quick to get to the finish line first here.
Well, Darius is now booking back to Candace Hudson.
Right behind them, Olivia is tagging off to Josh Saviano.
And there's Mayan Bialik. She's the final leg for the coral team. She's going to need every drop of water.
And Mario Lopez just getting back to Carolyn Plantain now, who must make up a lot of time.
Josh Saviano having a little bit of trouble negotiating those cones.
And the coral team break through for the victory. What a finish. There's still competitors on the course. Josh Saviano filling the glasses.
Candace Hudson, this Fuchsia team is also meticulously filling up those glasses.
Everybody right now going for second place here.
Every point counts.
Look at the concentration. Look at the precision. Look at how slow they're doing it.
Candace Hudson delicately trying to fill up the bucket.
You know, there's been a water shortage in California.
Yeah,
these kids are trying to take care of it now.
Right.
They're taking their time.
They might just do it.
Josh splitting, going back
Josh
to the finish line.
Tray. He has to go back and get it.
Oh, big mistake.
The team Candace Hudson is on the way back. I think she might do it.
Watch this, Commissioner.
Yes.
He left
just
his tray.
Carolyn is taking her. Tray might end up in a position here.
Saviano going all the way back. Oh, what is that going to cost the blue team?
The small details.
Well, it looks like the Fuchsia team Candace Hudson came in second.
Quite a race, ladies and gentlemen. Quite a race.
Yes, it was, Alex. It looks like a close one, Rain. Remember, they'll have to measure to see who got the most liquid, the coral team or the Fuchsia team.
You're right, Scott. This looks like it could be a tie. We'll have to see what the judges say. Now to you, Brian.
Okay, here we are with the Coral and the Fuchsia team. Now, because of the amount of water and the time, it was a tie for first. So, you guys caught up in points. Now, Coral is in second place, and Fuchsia is in third. It tightened up the gap. It did tighten up the gap now between you guys and the blue team. So hopefully in the next event you can make up some points and maybe pull on through.
Definitely.
Of course, Darius is still complaining that yesterday they did win an event that they didn't. But
it was the socks, I'm telling you.
And you did beat me, Mark. I can't stand it. You beat me. You got me. But
he beat you.
Yesterday was...
He beat you. Three words. He beat you.
As you can see, the tension is getting a little high here.
Let's take a look at the scores. The blue team stays in first, and because of the tie, the coral team tightens the gap. The fuchsia team pulls up to third, and the aqua team falls down to fourth place.
And now a word from our own Hans and Franz.
Hello, I'm Hans.
And I'm Franz.
And we're here to pump
you up. You know, we came down here today to help these little girly men actors and actresses, but I don't know if there's too much we can do. We saw them by the water today in their suits. What do you think?
Oh, it was terrible. Their legs, they look like pelicans.
They sure do. They're very little. They're very skinny. They're real pale. I don't know if they've been eating right.
Oh, they've been eating seeds and nuts. They should eat something good, like beef.
Big chunks of red meat. So we will work with them. I don't know if there's much we can do, but we'll keep trying.
And I'm Hans.
And I'm Franz, and we're here to pump. You up.
Now get your dictionaries ready, because we'll be back in a spell. We're back at Universal Studios Florida for our next event, the Alphabet Game. Two heats and a final. Each team must spell a word by placing discs on top of letters while skating on California Pro inline skates. In Heat 1, it was Zach Rutai, Brian, and Janelle Bishop of the Coral Team, and we learned very quickly that Zach had done this before. Adam Jeffries and Jill Setter for the Aqua Team spent more time on the ground than on their skates. In Heat 2, the Fuchsia Team's Jenna Van Oy and David Roden took on the Blue Team's Ashley Levitch and Jeremy Miller. All we can say about this heat is that it's not a demonstration of great inline skating. Jenna and David took the heat. And now here's Phil Moore for the final.
Right, we have Jenna and David, and Zachary and Janae.
The word is xylophone, xylophone, xylophone's the word. Ho ho! That's right, David, go, go. Xylophone, xylophone.
Zachary's coming down. Zachary, of course, is just cruising. Janelle and Jenna. And the body stop. They're doing it, all right. So far, we look pretty tight. We have pretty tight. Uh-oh, David had a little problem stopping there. He's got to grab it and go back. All right. Right now, it looks like the coral team is pulling out slightly ahead now. Xylophone. All right. Just put another one out for her team. Since we have six, two, three, four, five, six, seven over on the coral side. And David's bringing down the sixth one for his team. Right. We're going to search and to search. All right, another one down. Jenna's looking okay. And Janelle just put one down. And Zachary put another one down. All right, now, it looks like this. All right, David, through the leg action. Way to go, David. All right, looks like we have a spelling problem over on the coral team. Zachary and Janelle have to figure out. All right, Jenna puts it down and stays on her feet. All right. I think right now we're just checking spelling right now. All right. Coral team is being told they have nine down, but the word is spelled incorrectly. So they're going to have to check the spelling on xylophone. They have enough frisbees down, but they have to check the spelling. Checking spelling.
The final of the alphabet game was won by the Fuchsia team, who were skating for United Cerebral Palsy. Let's go down to Phil with the winning skaters.
The winners are the whole enchilada. David, Jenna, who? Right. Not even believing it. So what do you think? You pulled it off.
I think the most important thing was I told Zachary I'd beat him, and I did.
That little revenge thing. David, any final words?
I can't believe I did it pigeon-toed as I was.
Throwing the knee in skate. Hey, but listen, they won. They pulled it off. We're going to the next event. See ya.
Look at the scoreboard. Shows that after eight events, Easter Seals is ahead with 575, followed by Make-A-Wish, United Cerebral Palsy, and Mothers Against Drunk Driving. Now let's take a minute and look at some of the work done by Easter Seals. With advanced medical technology, doctors today can identify more unusual conditions than ever before. They're saving more premature babies, pulling more people through heart attacks and strokes, rescuing more victims of once fatal car crashes and accidents. But who picks up where the doctors leave off? Who teaches families the skills to make it through each day? Easter Seals does. We'll be back in Universal Studios Hollywood, where the kids must face the ups and downs of the Fievel's Playground Relay.
Back in the Sega Star Kids Challenge, let's catch up with what's been going down and up with Fievel's Relay Race so far. The first two teams have already completed the course.
The blue team put in a good effort. Joey Lawrence had a bit of trouble with the rollers, but he made good time. The team time was 1:41.16. The Aqua team, however, didn't fare quite as well. Their team time was 2:39.67. Chelsea Hertford must have thought she was going to spend the rest of her childhood climbing on that banana peel. But she did eventually make it up. And now, let's go to Rain Pryor with a team from United Cerebral Palsy.
We're back at the Sega Star Kids Challenge, and we're here with the Fuchsia team now. If you guys win this, you go on to compete against the blue team in the tug of war.
Yeah.
So, what's going to happen?
Well, we're just going to try to get in there and do our best. We got the little guys running for speed.
Hang down those
ankles. Here we go.
I'm kind of nervous, but...
I'm going to try to anchor it, you know, and try to make up for any time that's lost, and we're just going to do our best and... We're all praying that we win.
All right, there you have it from the Fuchsia team.
Gonna make it boom.
Okay, Rain, now Mark Pohl and company, you guys, no pressure, but if you beat the Fuchsia team, you're in the tug of war against the blue team.
Right.
What are you going to do?
We're going to beat them, and we're going to beat the blue team, too.
Really?
That's right.
Is that a prediction?
That's not a prediction.
That's not a prediction.
That is known, see?
Can you agree with that, Mark?
Oh, definitely. I think we have a really strong team, and we're just going to do our best.
Over?
There's no doubt about it.
You're all in?
Oh, definitely.
You're in there?
Yeah, Michelle.
You too?
Oh, yeah.
All right, well, you heard it. They're going to win it. Good luck here. All right, we'll see you later.
All right, first up on the course, the Fuchsia team with Jonathan Taylor Thomas from Home Improvement. Commissioner Golick gets him out of the gate. Take a look at him, Bob.
He's a fast kid, huh, Bob?
Good quick start. Now, he's got to come through the slingshot here, but as you see, he's got to go back. He's supposed to come up through the slingshot. Don't cheat, go the long way.
Oh, that time's going to cost this team.
Look at the last one. He's hit the soccer, skiing, basketball.
It shows. Look at him motor up that banana peel. Oh, on the first try. Nice job, Jonathan. Way to get up there.
And he touched up the Kansas Hudson of Evening Shade.
Candace into the maze. This is a tough part of the course.
Yeah.
Let's see how she does.
Have a little bit of trouble, a little bit of a problem there, tripping through the maze. We're getting confused. Where to go, Bob?
Well, you don't run into the camera. It's probably a good sign.
You could get lost in this place easy if you're a kid.
I'm lost already.
Unbelievable. Look at her battling her way through there. She'll find a way out, though.
Now, it's interesting. Her family moved here to Hollywood from Georgia to support her career.
And look where it got her. She's in the Fievel Playground. She taps off to her partner, Ashley Johnson, from Growing Pains. She's very active in the Make-A-Wish Foundation. Watch her motor.
She's flying through the course.
Look how fast she's going up that. Now, somebody with small feet you'd think would have a problem getting up that net like that, but not her.
That kid is a powerhouse. She motored up that net. Now she's coming out of the tunnel. She's ready to hit her partner. Look at her go. There's Darius McCrary waiting on the other end. He's going to pull this baby home for this team. Watch this guy motor. Darius looks like a football player. Commissioner, what do you think his potential?
He's got a lot of good moves. A couple more years maybe. But, you know, it looks like they really got the right people in the right position in this relay.
A little trouble on the rollers there. Coming down is all right, and
now he's going to make the run into
the bowl of balls. Into the ball cage. He's struggling to get the flag and head for the finish line. Here he comes. He's got to turn that corner quick. Good run. Good run for that team.
Nice race.
There he is. Good job, man. Very good job. Now, you guys made really good time, but you're up against the Coral team. We'll have to see how they do.
They banned.
And then between the two of you guys, it'll be who goes to the tug with the blue team. So you guys made really good time. Good luck. We'll see how the Coral team does. But you, great race, man. Great race. We'll see. Coral team coming up next.
Here's the time for the Fuchsia team. 1:56.38. Now the Coral team with Matthew Lawrence leading off. Let's see what kind of time they get. Nice smooth beginning for the race, no mistakes. Takes the right route. Yeah, he's clean through all the first hurdles. Now he's heading for the dreaded banana peel. Let's see how Matthew does.
No problem at all. Gets up there nice and easy.
Right through, clean exchange, and away goes Danny Pintaro. Danny into the maze. This is the toughest part of the course. Most of the competitors agree. Let's see how fast he gets through. I think he's a little lost there.
It does look like he's lost a little bit.
Kind of wandering around aimlessly. If Danny doesn't make up time here, they're in a lot of trouble. He's got to get over to Mayim Bialik, who's waiting to take it up that rope.
And
here
he goes at the end of that tag there.
Going to make her way up the cargo net now. Oh, very smooth.
Mayim
quickly up
that
the cargo net, down through the tunnel. Here she comes.
She's larger than the tunnel, so it's going to take a little more time for her.
Making up a lot of time for her team. Now she's going to tag off to Mark Paul Gosselaar, who's saved by the bell. Both teams finishing with their big athletes. Let's see if Mark Paul can bring it home. It looks like this may be the most athletic portion of the relay. A lot of combination, a lot of things, weaving, running up the rollers.
Going to the bowl of balls next. See how well he does in there.
He's got to get that flag and get out because his time is running short.
Very well. Very fast time.
Oh, he didn't get hung up at all. Look at him go.
Excellent run.
And that's going to do it for him with a time of 1:28.10. What a job. What do you think, Bob? Well, you know, the Fuchsia team was very smooth, but I think you see here that not only was the Coral team smooth, but they were much quicker.
Congratulations, guys. Great time. Great time. Great time. Coral team is now in the tug-off against the blue team. So, what was the biggest hang-up, you think?
Nothing.
Nothing. Smooth run. Smooth run by the Coral team. Congratulations, guys. See you all in the tug-off.
And look at the scoreboard. The blue team been in first all day. They're still there. Second place is the Coral team. They'll be in the tug-of-war, those two. Third place is Fuchsia. Fourth place goes to Aqua. And now let's spend some quality shopping time with our star kid, Kelly Martin, who plays Becca on Life Goes On.
I live in jeans. I think everybody in California lives in jeans. I'm pretty casual. When I go to the set every day, I wear very casual clothes, and it's fun when I get to go to benefits or dressy things, and I really get to dress up. So fashion-wise, I'm very relaxed, but when I get to dress up, you know, I go all out, so not... No. On Mondays, I have to be at the set at 6:30, so... It's very early, so I have to get up at like 5 a.m. and then I work all day and I go to school about 3 hours a day with my tutor. So I basically don't get to stop all day until I get home. I do my homework, I learn my lines, and I go to bed. That's my life during the week. It's very stressful, but I love it, so it's okay. And balancing school and work is really hard, but I somehow do it. And the weekends are pretty much mine, and I just do whatever I want. So work is work, although it's fun, but when I'm at work, I'm almost a different person because I'm being very professional, you know, doing my job, but it's still fun at the same time. So we do a lot for Down syndrome, the Down Syndrome Congress, and parents. I don't think I will ever feel more appreciated than when I am at these functions where especially the Downs kids are. They are so, they just think that Corky and Becca are just the best. It's so neat. So I do a lot for them. And I think it's my responsibility. I think that kind of comes with the territory. And I think I'm very lucky to be able to do this for these people. I think that's my job.
Get a good grip. We're coming right back for the finale of the Sega Star Kids Challenge, the Tug of War. And now back to the final contest of our Sega Star Kids Challenge, the Tug of War. There's the Commissioner Bob Golic ready to start it up.
Go!
Our first start, Alex. Josh Saviano pulling the lead.
Easter Seals
for the
battling.
Easter Seals team.
Make a Wish on the other end, trying like crazy to gain some leverage.
And the Make a Wish team has one more player on their team, Alex, which may be a big difference here.
Could be a big difference.
Joey Lawrence pulling anchor.
Equal weight, Lawrence against Lawrence, Easter Seals against Make a Wish, everything on the line.
And Matthew Lawrence pulling and Mark Paul Gasol just got kicked in the face.
In the head. Unbelievable how hard these teams are trying.
It's getting very close.
Very close. The feet are slipping. The hands are getting weak.
Make-A-Wish team is pulling that flag. Pulling it towards their side.
Unbelievable. Easter Seals has got to get back in this thing soon.
And here they come. Oh, wait a minute. And the Make-A-Wish team pulls it out.
It is over. Unbelievable.
Easter Seals are winning all day, and the Make-A-Wish team pulls out the victory.
How is that to come from behind? All day they've been looking up.
Uh-huh.
Last event, they pull it out. Let's go to the victors.
The prediction. You predicted you guys would have it. Tell me about it.
Well, like I said, we were always first or second. Not first, but second or third. And what happens is the points keep mounting up. And then I knew we'd come to this. And I was not sure if we were going to win or not, but let me tell you, we sure gave it all. What I was planning to do is just get everybody in here and just have it, like, one-on-one, no matter what the points were. And that's what we did.
Well, good job, guys. Congratulations.
And now the awards. And remember, the Sega Star Kids Challenge, everybody's a winner. Here's a check for $23,000 for the fourth place team, Mothers Against Drunk Driving. All right, guys. And in third place, receiving $24,000 is the team for United Cerebral Palsy. Coming in second and getting a check of $26,000 is Easter Seals. All right. And our grand prize winner, who gets a check for $27,000, Make-A-Wish. Congratulations to every competitor and every team for a fine effort. You should all feel very proud of yourselves. Way to go, guys. Way to go. Good stuff. Well, I guess it's almost time to say goodbye for the Sega Star Kids Challenge Universal Studios Hollywood. But first, let's say goodbye to Fillmore in Orlando and his great group of Sega Star Kid competitors.
Hey, well, that is it from Universal Studios Florida. We'd like to thank our valiant competitors here and winners and seconds and thirds and fourths. We had an excellent time, and it was all for a great cause, right? All right. Hey, listen, Scott, Rain, hey, we had a great time here in Orlando, and we hope next time we will see you in Hollywood, or else maybe you can come and hang out here with us at Universal Studios Florida. Bye. See you later. Bye.
We've seen our Star Kid teams make some amazing efforts today, and it's all been for a really great cause. Did you guys have fun?
Yeah, all right. How about you guys? You have fun? You have a good time here today?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I've been missing for the world.
It's good to have you guys on board. And Bob, I want to thank you for being our commissioner. You were great. Did you have a good time?
I had a great time. Yeah. It was my pleasure, Scott. You know, this job's going to look very good on my resume.
Maybe someday I'll get in my own league.
Why not?
If you do, don't forget to draft Fievel or one of our teams.
Well, we've had a blast here today. We hope you did, too. We'll see you next time on the Sega Star Kids Challenge. All right.
Wardrobe for Sega Star Kids Challenge provided by Bum Equipment. Air transportation provided by U.S. Air with 2,600 flights a day to over 170 cities, including London, Frankfurt, and Paris. Everything we do, U.S. Air, begins with you. The Sheraton Universal Hotel, the official hotel of Universal Studios Hollywood, is just steps away from King Kong, E.T., Earthquake, and all the excitement of Universal Studios Hollywood.